Hello everyone, this is Rimal, HOD, Department of IMBA, BJB Autonomous College. I welcome you to Odisha State Open University. Let's get into the world of marketing management. In marketing management, it is very important to know about what is the core concept of marketing or what are the core concepts of marketing. And core concepts of marketing, it is nothing but the core set of some of the concepts. And later on, we'll discuss about all those concepts that really that contribute towards the total core concept of the marketing. One by one, we'll discuss. Let's go to the first one. It is needs, wants, and demand. It is very well-known words. You might have come across all those words regularly, but in marketing terms, let us understand what is need, what is want, and what is demand. So, need can be said as it is the basic requirement. For example, water, air, food, shelter. All those basic requirements. That means we need something. It can be water, it can be cold drink, it can be something else. So, that is the basic requirement. And when a particular need becomes specific. For example, I am hungry. That means by need, I require food. But when I say I want a burger or I want pizza or I want dosa, so I am becoming specific. So here need becomes want. And that is the situation. Again, this want becomes the demand. Like want becomes demand when it is backed by the willingness and the purchasing power of the customer. That means if you are willing to buy something but you are not good enough or you are not rich enough to buy all those things. For example, you are willing to buy Mercedes but you are not able to get it because of your economic condition. That means you cannot say Mercedes in the demand. So something in demand, it can be told when it is backed by the purchasing power or capability to buy. So it is all about need, want, and demand. Second concept, it goes like segmentation, targeting, positioning. Fondly, it is called as STP, like segmentation. We know that it is division, or we can say this, dividing a bigger heterogeneous market into relatively similar kind of homogeneous market. Suppose in total medicine companies, they will select to cater only infants or baby. So in that case, we are just putting a particular segment, we are dividing into segment, we are just pulling out only babies or you can say infants. In that case, we are getting the division or the segmentation. And here, segmentation of the four types, it is just like, you know, geographic, demographic, psychographic, and behavioral. After those division, then again, it requires targeting, which segment to be targeted. Target market, because there is no company which can target all those customers. It has its own set of target market. So targeting. So it is selecting a particular group which can be included as its target customer or target market which company intends to serve. And positioning. Positioning means it is just putting a particular product's image into customer's mind. For example, whenever we think of Sony, Sony is perceived like it is a technologically sound company, and that is the positioning. So positioning, just like it can be multiple positioning also. For example, in Johnson's and Johnson baby shampoo, years back, they have positioned as a baby product because it has very mild chemicals for baby. But years later, it was positioned as it can be also useful for the ladies, like this baby shampoo or baby lotion that can be used by the ladies also, which can make those ladies' skin baby soft. So that is called the positioning. And after that, another concept comes, market. Exactly, what is the market? It is that particular collection of the buyers and sellers. And here, the market can be again divided into different types, like the consumer market, the business market, the global market, as well as it is non-government market or non-profit market and government market. Apart from that, other markets are there, but broadly, we get into the four types of markets. Products, it can be tangible as well as intangible. They can give the tangible as well as the intangible benefits. Product can be again divided into two types, goods and services. So goods is tangible and service is intangible. And another concept is competition. Competition means it is the competition in the market, where competition is of the different kinds, and where competition is good for a particular market, because it really makes quality, it really makes price less, as well as customers, they are benefited because they get better choice, number of options. So competition is healthy and good for a particular market. Customer value and satisfaction, it is another concept. Here we consider as a value. Whenever customer is expecting something and exactly the delivery by the company, it matches with the expectation. That means it is worthy, or customer gets the value. And customer value is really involved towards the three value triads. And those are, they're called as price, service, and quality. Here, quality and service should go up in a direction. But in that case, price should be down. That means when you get good quality product as well as good service in less price, that means you are getting more value. That means you are company, as a company, you are able to deliver a value product. The value can be again tangible value and intangible. Again, satisfaction. Satisfaction means every customer has some expectation from a particular product. When a company is able to deliver that, when it matches or it exceeds, in that case, a customer is said to be satisfied. And it is a essence, or you can say it is a objective of the marketing to make the customer satisfied. The customer satisfaction, it is just the trade-off between the expectation and the delivery. Exchange and relationships. Exchange, that is the essence of the marketing. There is always an exchange. There is an exchange of value, exchange of idea, exchange of the product, exchange of the service. And for which something is exchanged in terms of monetary, in terms of non-monetary also. So that is the exchange is the essence of the marketing, as well as relationship. In recent times, marketing management really focuses on the relationship, because relationship matters, because customer is the king. And that company survives which can retain back its customer with the relationship. For that reason, many of the companies, they're focusing on a particular department called CRM department, which really focuses on the customer's services. And today, the objective of the many of the companies, not to make customers satisfied, rather to make the customer delighted. So all those things, they will be called as the core set of concepts which really make the core concepts of marketing. So all the companies, they focus on different sets of those core concepts to make their product, to make the total market valuable, successful. And ignoring all those things, marketing cannot be possible. So this is all about core concepts of marketing. Thank you very much.